time for us to get to the game. It is not a joke. Do not adjust your sets. We've got the Super Bowl in CSGO commentators, Anders and Semler.
It is peekaboo. He's been spotted and he is dead. Glaive cast off the side of the building. His teammate will fall next, and VSM doing a very fine job holding. Weirdest way to draw a knife. I don't know about you.
Ooh, that's a nice double spray, and it's more than a nice shot for VSM. I mean, they're all here fighting. The spray continues, and it's TRK with a big double. And now they are up against Sip. He's gonna at least take down one. They must know that he's low by now. And yeah, he's waiting, wants to see if TRK wants to make any kind of a mistake. The bomb is there, and he's walking right into it. A little bit of a grenade around the corner. VSM still holding here, and yeah, they're gonna be right in front of him, not even checking it at all. Magus turning around, and he's almost going down. This is a bit of a disaster. 40 seconds left. He's gonna pick up that AK-47, and yeah, he's gonna get that kill on Magus. Pretty well played here, and epically.
Yeah, but everybody on A, if they hit B, cool. We save our guns for the next round, and we're fine. Hunky-dory, whatever. We've still got a good buy going into the last round of the half. If they come here, we smash them. It's exactly what happened, and it's Astralis without a bomb plant who have to go for a bit of a janky buy here. AK on device, but no nades.
Or actually one on three, make it back around, and do they have a smoke for the bomb? That's pretty huge if they do. Yes, they do. Inside of it, Dupree spraying, and he's gonna be too late. 8-7, who would have thought, is MIBR to pick up the lead at the end of the half. And how sad they all looked at it in a way.
And now you even have Magus joining the fight. Things are about to get real spicy here for MIBR.
Waiting for it, almost getting caught. There's the Galil versus AK though. Could be really tricky. And Magus trying to suss him out. Oh, he's being played with, he's being toyed with it, TRK! Picking up a triple and just stealing. That was at a 2-on-4 that they ended up winning. And Astralis really just had to stay out of the line. 9 seconds on the board. They need to get this bomb plant down, and they're not going to be allowed. Round is definitely done. Just run, Sip. You have to make it around the corner, and he's hunting him. He's got the right idea, Leo. He knew. I was fooling myself a little bit into thinking they were closer. Well, now's the time. 14-14. Ooh, and he jumped over it.
Their device is going to be feeling a bit frustrated for himself. Overpeaking that angle ends up costing him. You can see here, takes that shot, but the smoke grenade killed him. Okay, then.
No, did that really happen?
That really happened.
I can't believe it. I didn't even realize. I've been waiting for that for years. And now I was so freaked out. Oh, God. Let's see. Yeah, they're waiting for it. They're listening. Actually, they just get shot for the smoke. But again, they're definitely waiting for the bomb. Lucas has got the health, but no, it doesn't even, they just cannot get that bomb down. It doesn't matter what they're doing as soon as they walk in. Now they're going to turn the corner, and Lucas fighting back in style. KNG will be dropped, and now there's no time here again. There's no way they can get back. It's going to be 15-15. It's overtime.
That's some very solid patience getting shown here by MIBR. There's the shot. Misses it. Fluffed it completely. Oh, Dupree!
Here's on, right? You're like, oh shit, we should be doing this. VSM, nice spray down, and KNG is there with the AWP just needed.
Considering the opening that they had at the beginning of that round with the successful lobby push, and then Glaive denying the defuse. But he's got to win! All on Zip now to redeem himself, and he is not going to hit that shot initially, but that time is ticking.
Yes, it is. And TRK, I don't know, he's got maybe one chance here. He's going to tap it, shoulder peek us out, and now he knows. I think Sip's got this one. Not quite as clean as maybe you would have seen. You would have loved that straight headshot, but it is absolutely acceptable. Gone. There's the Deagle. He's turned back for it. Just going to be dropping down. But again, how is he supposed to guess this? The best choice might just be to hold it in for the minute. VSM coming in for the execution, and he'll definitely get it.
Oh! Oh!
I'm going to count that as just the best kind of BM you could possibly do.
That's right, KMG, we're watching you.
All right, here we go. Boom, boom. Like,
as talented as Zipmix as well.
Yeah.
He's really not going to miss that chance, but this... Okay, so he was already scoped up and ready for it. Nicely done.
I love this kind of play. He's going to be walking in, and he's going to take over this bomb site on his own. What a genius. Back looking for Sip. He's knocking them all out. What a next level play from Leo. That is perfect. Device in a 1v3, and he has been caught and found. 16-13. MIBR will grant us that third map. It's going to be on Inferno, ladies and gentlemen.
unnecessary. Dupree is going to be his first point of contact, though. There's the bait. Nicely done by Dupree. Opens it up. KNG not even be able to peek behind it. They know where Lucas is coming from, and it's Dupree.
Dupree had been, he'd been out towards Banana, so he knew that no one was coming there. And he's going to get shut down. TRK, it's all on him. Oh, and maybe not. KNG still here. I didn't even realize. And that's going to be the kill. And that's going to be the round. They can't win it now. VSM just has to stay out of sight. Oh, what a save. Now, can they get the bomb down? That would have been an absolutely disgusting headshot. He gets it anyway. He could go almost straight for it. I don't know if VSM is going to realize. Yeah, he's going to hold it in shorty the whole way through. VSM just jiggling it a little bit. And there's the headshot for Magus. Oh my god. A couple of absolutely godlike kills coming in this round.
He has a duo over here trying to control the area. They will. Shot goes in. Device. He just obliterates KNG. That's the SCAR 20 in action. Now he's just going to go ahead and start hunting with him. Why not?
He will used to be so mad when someone did this. It's going to work. He's flashed. Oh, there's definitely going to be Cummins. It's so fair, but it doesn't matter. It is. There's something hilarious about it. Listen, MIBR, I don't think we're going to do anything anyway this map. It doesn't matter. It's still an amazing performance in overall, but it will be Astralis to pick up the win. It took all three maps, but their Inferno performance was unquestionably much, much stronger.
We're starting with Mirage. We've got Launders and Scorny to bring you all the action, and there'll be no bias coming out here. They're not North American, they're not European, but they're here to deliver amazing Counter-Strike.
Elf duels Caserato somehow.
Yep, Henny will trade though. You know, last round we saw Henny starting the round. Now he's getting his contact in the middle of it all. Cat player just jumped down bottom mid, and Henny predicts it.
Well, which is the most important piece of the puzzle for them. But oh my god.
Easily slept away, gets interesting, nice flash. Oh, it's a triple, nearly the quad, comes back, and Caserato's gonna kill him instead. Carrier, while Hunter's trying to fight here towards the CT spawn, Art's gonna shank him. Down goes the bomb. Hunter has no clue that Art was able to slip back in, and an off shot to close.
To die is one thing, but to die without dignity is another.
Two over towards the jungle, a smoke on top of the bomb. Aminek, he's in the process of sticking this down to a second left, and he gets it all the way through.
How did he get the defuse off? Was he, the bomb was planted on the outside of triple. Was he stuck behind a box or not? Because he had one hit left over.
Just dead center smoke sticking through the defuse.
Wow, he actually managed to, stuck far away from it as possible. We see the bullets whiz by where the bomb was down, not expecting Omnek to be that far out. Really nice calmness from Omnek to...
You know, G2 props to a T-side on their map pick, but, you know, furious T-sides can be their area of expertise. However, Nico, an expert in and of himself, predicts this third peak, and now he has gone everything so far. Yuri and Caserato left over. Here comes the pistol peek. So far, so good. Yuri with the 3K. Caserato is going to get denied. Capable with the deke. And UMP in the mix. Kenny, a palace. It's underneath. And sandwich, they have to clear. Kenny S, crucial kill. Yuri, he's got that first one, but now Kenny's honing in on him. He's tucked as can be, and he delivers with a 10th round for Furia.
Like, am I on even footing for at least the first kill? Because if I can do that, then maybe we can guarantee the rounds. Mm-hmm. And for the longevity of the economy, we can buy more often.
Now towards Catwalk, he does take a bit of chip damage, but Aminek can lend a helping hand. A perfect 3K with the AUG. Headshot after headshot after headshot. Yeah, what's coming? It's about stopping it in its tracks. Aminek, a second frag, a third frag, and looking for more. As Furia, they kick in the door, but can't quite get to have fallen silent because they want Kenny to catch the kill. He does, and now Yuri is going to have to do it all. He uses the Galil to best Hunter, peeks into Nexa, and dies. G2 Esports survive on Mirage. Wow. The types of rounds they won to do this, absolutely huge. Six-round lead to close, denying Furia a map one win.
A player dead, and the second straggler will maybe die as well.
Oh, hang on. Two versus three, damage done.
That's true. What's actually kind of interesting about that is it feels like a couple of times now, they know someone's got lower. Yeah, they look like fools, but Caserato opened things up. That's Hunter on squeaky duty, and they knew the vent was not covered. They snuck down. Kenny S was too scared to drop a shot, and we know that they've been very slow to rotate to the lower site.
Yeah.
But this time, the threat was not in the 5v5. No, no more. Is this time is for Furia. I think the real key here is don't fake. Go for the outside to lower hits.
From this direction, Kenny S, the first contact. Vinny, it's a labored spray, but he transitions over to Nexa, and he gets the job done.
It couldn't have been more critical. Vinny, the man who you had to shine a spotlight on from the first map that was not putting up numbers, puts together one of the most critical rounds of this match, if not the most, for Furia. Destroys the economy of G2 one more time. They took their eighth round already. There's the entry to start things out. Probably the hardest part about all of this in the first place. Saves Caserato's life by a hair, and then turns it into the 1v2. Drops a spray on Kenny S. You think he's gonna lose focus? No. That's not Vinny.
M4 does good damage, and Nexa's off angle finds Art by surprise. Now, Kenny, he's actually coming in on the hot flank and could get caught. Flashbang into the eyes of Vinny. Nexa going huge.
Flush it.
All the way around from heaven. He's crawling into hut. 10 seconds left, and he gets the first headshot. There's still time to bail them out of trouble, but they need to go, and they need to go now. It's Hunter and Nico running in for the plant. They get it in the nick of time, and the last two CTs both have ops. Nico doing everything. He has unraveled this ball of yarn. Yuri shocked, and Henny ready to rock this 1v2 back to Furia's favor. He's inside of the smoke. He turns his head, and Henny should be dead, but he's gone all the way around. He has seen nothing. As quickly as they conquered, they have disappeared. Henny scopes in, gives himself up, dropped to 16 health. He's gonna try and get on bomb. A ridiculous 2v4 by the Kovacs.
Yeah, absolutely unreal. I mean, at that from Nico is known. And the integration with Nexus calling has been fantastic.
Worked so quick. Art, 16 HP. I'm sorry, folks, but this one's done and dusted. G2 with a hell of a debut over top of North America's best hope, at least here on the opening day of Group 3. The thing is, tomorrow now, we get the Brazilian Bonanza, and we have Astralis versus G2 to try and top the group.
It's time for us to get out of here, and I'm not really sorry to Pimp. He's always wrong, and he'll continue to be wrong. I've had his mute muted, so he can't even talk back. We got Astralis going up against G2 next. Then it's Furia going up against MIBZR, the Brazilian backlash. Pimp's out of here. Me and Maynek. Maynek, do you want to say something?
No, I'm good. I'm good. I've said everything I wanted to say.
Because you're smart, and you're right, and so am I. So good night, everybody. We'll see you later. Ha 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 ha!